Today, I will share with you how to look for valuable NFTs according to your budget. I will give you some tips on how to choose potential NFTs that will grow in value, and I will demonstrate it step by step. So right now I am on OpenSea.io, and if I click on marketplace, we will see all of the NFTs that are available, and there are many. Okay, we have over 16 million NFTs. As you know, some are cheap, others are expensive. So it really depends on how much you can afford to spend for an NFT. Okay, you should decide what your budget is, rather than just go around and like an NFT which is much more than what you are planning initially to spend. So don't take it as a financial advice, but what I would usually do when I'm planning to purchase an NFT, for example, I decided I will be buying an NFT for $500, then I'm looking for an NFT that is within this price range. Okay, and now my wallet is funded with 0.0194 of Ethereum. For the purpose of this video, I will be using that amount, and this is approximately $41.58, but in May and June 2021, the Ethereum and all the cryptos lost more than 50% of their values. But anyway, that's the amount that I'll be spending, okay? But this is, one more time, for the purpose of this video, don't take it as a recommendation. I just wanted to pick a small amount which I will be using for demonstrational purposes. Okay, so if this is my budget, 0.0194, so what can I do? I can set a price range on OpenSea. It could be in dollars or it could be in Ethereum. And I will switch to Ethereum. I will go for 0.0194, okay? Because this is how much I have currently in my wallet. And I want to look for NFTs that are within this price range. Okay, so this is my maximum. And if I apply, you will see all the results. And these are actually 124,946 results, if I have to be precise. So all of these NFTs are within this range. So one more time, if you are planning to spend $100, 0.05 Ethereum or 0.1 Ethereum, then you can just put it in the filter and look for all the NFTs that are in this price range. The next thing I like to do when filtering NFTs is to use the sort by option, and we have plenty of options here. We can see NFTs that were recently listed, recently created, or recently sold, and we have a few more options, but what I like to use is most favorited, which means that they will have more like or kind of hearts. But on the top you can see that we have this heart icon, which if I tap on it, I will increase the number with one. I just need to confirm it, and here it is, okay? And then I can unfavorite it. But my point of view is that I want to look for NFTs that people like, okay? Because if it's the other way around and you buy an NFT that no one liked, you will probably have hard times reselling it after that. Okay, so let's look at some of the first results. We have those oops, which is from KluCoin. Well, actually the first two, and this one is from the same seller. And then we have a few more. Actually, this Monas is quite interesting, honestly. Celebrating Reddit. You see a smoking Mona with glasses, and then she's holding kind of baby with the Reddit icon. Interesting dress as well. But let's have a look at the others as well. So I will just click randomly on any of them. Let's click on the first one that has the most favorites. So you can see that we have 26,700 pieces in total, which is a huge number, okay? We have a lot of views, a lot of favorites, and the average price goes just sideways, all-time average price. And recently we have increasement, which is great, but it is based on small number of sales, all right? You can see number of sales 3, And if I scroll down, here are the listings of all the NFTs from this collection. And you can see that the price was more expensive, but the recent listings were at about $40 to $20. And if I scroll lower, you will see the trading history. It was listed about 2 days ago, what I see. And just what's the concern here with me is that this recent increasement in the sales is based on just 3 sales, okay? And for me, honestly, I'm not really impressed with this NFT. I personally prefer to like the idea of NFT. And let me click on that one with Among Us, which grabbed my attention because of so many different things in one simple picture, okay? And it's about Reddit, which is a huge forum for NFTs and for crypto especially. So what we have here, 1,000 total NFTs, which is much better. We have already 687 owners. We have views and favorites, which is great. This is the average price, which decreases, and here it increases again. It recently increased a little bit based on a few sales again. But you see that all-time average price is 0.0099, while I can buy it for 0.008. And if I scroll down, you will see the listings, and here is the trading history, okay? So let's see what we have in the trading history. It starts from about 16 days ago. Already many people bought, and all right, looks pretty decent. Not really the best NFT I could look for, but I don't want to make the video too long where I'll be scrolling around different NFTs. Just wanted to give you the idea that we want to have NFT collection which recently increases in price, and it's better if you have more number of sales. At the same time, you want to see that people are buying it. So I will just buy this NFT for the purpose of this video as a demonstration. And then one last thing, you should have a look at the creator, okay, created by Monas, and we can see the main collection at this URL. Let me just quickly open it so we can see what exactly we have in there. Probably we will see similar NFTs with Mona that represent different things. And yep, exactly, we have over 1,000 items. We have average price of 0.03 and already 14.9 Ethereum volume traded. So yep, different Monas, very similar to the one we saw. So I can look for something more interesting or something that will grab my attention more, or if you find more value in any of those, or if you're a fan of Tesla, for example, or if you want to have a Mona with Dogecoin or with Kitty. You see a lot of things combined into one. But what's interesting here is that actually people are buying these Monas. And I will be just buying the first one that I've noticed for the purpose one more time of the video. And I will just demonstrate how it works. I will click on buy now. I have some summary. I have reviewed this information. And this is the correct collection. I will tap on continue. And then what I have, it's about $16.75. or 0.008 of Ethereum. I will just check out, and then I will click on convert, which opens the MetaMask notification bar. And you can see that I will be paying gas fee of 0.001751, which is approximately $3.78. Okay, so this example gives you an idea how much gas fee I will be paying for such an NFT. And then I will click on confirm, and then it will take a few seconds for the deposit to go through into Polygon, and then I will show you the next steps. So bear in mind that we always have gas fees. Some people predict, and there are some plans for updates on the Ethereum network, that the gas fees will be removed. Personally, I'm a bit skeptical because of many reasons. If it happens, of course, it will be great. It will be very bad for the miners because they will be getting less, but this is for the future. We don't know if this will happen or not. Okay, I will continue the video just once we have the deposit ready, so I won't make it too long. All right, in a few minutes time, I see the message that says, wait for deposit. Your deposit is pending and may take about 10 minutes. You may leave this page or keep this model open and check back later. All right, so I'll give it another 10 minutes and I will continue the video then. All right, here we go. In a few minutes time, I need to unlock currency, or the message says submit a transaction with your wallet to trade with this currency. This only needs to be done once, and I click on unlock. And again, I'm forwarded to the MetaMask wallet and I will just sign it. And it's loading, unlock currency, transaction successful. And then sign a message using your wallet to continue. I will click on sign again. And then one more time, I will just click on sign. And here we go, it's processing. It says, what? You just purchased Mona celebrating Reddit 2021. It's been confirmed on the blockchain and here is the transaction hash. And here we go. And now if I scroll lower in the trading history, here it is from GSMO57. There was the transfer and the sale for 0.008 of Ethereum 2 minutes ago to you or to me. All right, so the transfer is ready. If I click on my profile, it's still unnamed. I have created for the purpose of the video. So here it is. It is inside my wallet and I am already the owner of this quite interesting NFT. One more time that I have selected quickly and bought to demonstrate how exactly it works. Really easy, by the way, you just follow the steps. And here it is, the NFT is right into my wallet. I can give it another favorite actually. All right guys, so it is that easy to purchase an NFT from OpenSea, very similar from the other marketplaces. And if you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. I'll be more than happy to assist you if I know the answer of your question. Or if you have just experience in purchasing, selling NFTs, drop them below. So this way the video you will be useful for everyone watching it. And if you have found the video useful, don't forget to give it a huge like. And I will see you guys in the next one. Take care. Bye.